Cities and architecture have long been creating orders and demarcating ourselves from nature to improve our comfort in architectural design. Nonetheless, plants are still thriving tenaciously in the old town Lao under the highly controlled urban environment. Yau Ma Tei, one of the oldest districts in Hong Kong, has a variety of town Lao, also known as tenement buildings, in different generations. The materiality of this low-rise town Lao typology is prone to be deteriorated by parasitic plants under the humid subtropical climate and human activities. This pre-existing natural and tropic phenomenon, in fact, entails the interest of developers in Hong Kong to use it as a weapon in their conspiracy. According to the Land Compulsory Sale for Redevelopment Ordinance, it allows developers who have already acquired at least 80% of an old building to use compulsory purchase orders to gain full ownership and renovate them into new residential towers. Consequently, developers started to manipulate this ordinance and hire gangsters to secretly plant seeds in the crack of the rooftop and let the root of the plants sabotage town Lao gradually. By doing so, they are able to force eviction of the residents. This is not a one-off incident. A total of 200 pre-war and post-war town Lao are facing the same fate. Approximately 37,000 households and 105,000 people are affected by this redevelopment site, mostly located in Kowloon. The emblematic Hong Kong culture and our way of life are under threat. The series of plant attack is a catalyst of forming a local bottom-up initiative with the agency of symbiotic means to backfire on the manipulation of developers. By subverting this inevitable entropic process, the project is turning destructive force into a preservative power and seeks to establish a coexistent relationship between residents, buildings, and plants. Inspired by the notion of wrapping from crystal and jean cloth, which monuments are completely concealed and suffocated by cloth. In contrast, the project explores a different means of wrapping. The town Lao are preserved and remain intact via a breathable and growing layer of wrap. Historically, there are typologies of thinking about facade in relation to the organic world like the Art Nouveau, where motifs and architectural elements were heavily mimicking nature. Developing from that, recent Greenland typologies like green walls has the intention to remediate poor air qualities and radio temperature. However, the drawback of it is that it is highly controlled. Plants are isolated by pots, which stops their communication in the root system, consequently leads to lack of biodiversity. The project is pushing this intention further, developing beyond mimicry, decorative, and isolated approach. Plants are seen as a part of the building system and encourage them to thrive organically, allowing communication in their root systems. This biological wrap works just like a human body. Bricks are mounted by steel wires at first and later tangled with the growing roots and branches, woven a breathing skein. It controls the temperature of town Lao by the cooling and shading function of the plants. They are then anchored onto a skeleton, the bamboo scaffolding. It is a traditional method to build skyscrapers in Hong Kong due to its sustainability and low-cost sourcing. The water pipes of irrigation system aligned along the wall of the existing building are diverted horizontally at each level. They are like veins and arteries, carrying rooftop runoff to filter and pumping the clean water back to the plants. The filtration room functions like a heart, where it keeps water circulates and keeps the skin alive. A simultaneous growth, decay, and maintenance will continue to cycle in the tenement buildings. Since bricks are a medium for plant growth, a series of experiments are undertaken to test the material of the bricks. The result of brick with a mixture of soil, compost, and clay is more favorable for germination. The brick design is developed from the growing behavior and characteristics of four native species. They are carefully selected to provide different functions for both the building and residents. Chinese banyan trees are widely planted in Hong Kong because of its excellent shade, quick growth, and high resilience to damage. Its roots can reach up to 20 meters, and robust knots are formed during its expansion to strengthen its structure. The engraved pattern of the brick follows the characteristic of its roots, which gives us directions for banyan to grow. Like the Ban Milis Temple in Cambodia, where it finds entangling walls and columns and the roots holding the structure. Climbing bohinia was first discovered in Hong Kong, and its flower is adopted as the regional emblem. Its tendrils are key to reach around and search for something they can climb up with. Responding to its tendrils' behavior, the brick emphasizes on linearity, and apertures are formed when bricks are laid out, so that it has sufficient space to curl around. Wood fern can be easily found parasitizing on Tan Lao, especially near water sources. The brick design responds to the continuous horizontal growth of its rhizomes. The extensive root system of common reed can filter chemical and organic pollutants. Responding to that, the high porosity of the brick allows water and roots to penetrate through. It also functions like a sponge. The concave surfaces can hold moisture and soil and allow seeds to grow from. These bricks are biological entities to promote plants' growth in a symbiotic way. In a socio-political dimension, these bottom-up initiatives foster new housing mechanism in Hong Kong, the Tan Lao Garden Cooperative's housing scheme. It is a direct collaboration and agreement between the government and the cooperatives. This community-led conservation movement is formed by the residents in Tan Lao collaborating with district-based community groups like Community March and HKCC. The scheme is to solve another urban problem in exchange for the developer's redevelopment plan, which is the lack of green spaces. Government often has to squeeze out additional empty plots for gardens and playgrounds in this high-density environment. Hence, the cooperatives will offer Tan Lao as a green buffer zone and open up rooftops as public spaces, while continuing living in their home and guarding the local community. Financially, the cooperatives will receive funding from LCSD for the maintenance of plants and pay the construction fees themselves. This alternative conservation plan not only preserves the distinctive Hong Kong's way of life, but also brings impetus to green development.
It has been 25 years in the blink of an eye. The banyan trees have reached their mature age. It kind of recalls how we have started this alternative preservation and living with them these years.
Wait. 陳師奶啊? 沒啊, 我種了些菜, 打給你看看你什麼時候回家, 我拿些去給你吃。
I always come and sit here whenever I want to escape from the busy city. It's funny, the reed bed filters water, but the tranquil ambience cleanses my mind.
Over
time, plants thrive, bamboo rot. Some bricks disintegrate, some remains. The interweaving network of roots and branches becomes denser and tougher, forming a cladding of greenness. The symbiotic rep is advocating for a true coexistence between nature and architecture. embracing and transforming entropy into a symbiotic preservative power.